all the comfy seats, so I had to sit in one of those chairs. You know, so they keep them.
Well, yours doesn't.
No, it's on the host.
On the host.
Do you want to sit here? I'm going to tell you, I'm not going to deny Darth Vader. Go ahead.
Yes.
Oh, no, that's the seat. Oh, this seat. That seat's even more comfortable.
I mean, it is the bed.
Oh, this seat's like boring next to that.
Yeah.
It's like, is that muscle? Okay, I was thinking maybe we could talk about Star Wars instead of furniture.
What do you guys want?
Furniture?
You don't want to talk about leathers and that, right?
Okay. So, you know, congratulations on your epic performance of Darth Vader in Rogue One. I thought it was great to see him when he came out.
And
he showed the credit. That was a fantastic scene. I thought maybe a good opening question would be, you know, how'd you get the part? How'd you audition for it? What was it like finally get it?
Well, it was like a lot of my characters I auditioned, you know, but this was in the beginning, the first audition I had a cell tape back in my agency in Manchester, and it was very, very secretive. We didn't even know who the character was, he just had great importance. And when I was doing the dialogue, we were going through the dialogue, I was saying to my agent, I said, I got 33 minutes of Darth Vader. And he goes, no, it's not. No, I said, I'm telling you now. He goes, why are you saying that? Because at the end of each line, he's going, but no, I just, you know, the second callback, he still didn't release the character's name. And then on the third callback at Pinewood Studios, then we were told it's Darth Vader. So when then they put us right, they stuck me in because I've done a lot of work in Pinewood Studios.
Was that Chewbacca?
No. So yeah, the last audition was at Pinewood Studios. I've done a lot of work at Pinewood Studios, so, and because it was very secretive, they snuck me in, snuck me through the gates, snuck me upstairs, did me thing, went back home, and then just waited by the phone. So, but it was such a moment when I walked into this little room in Pinewood Studios, and they drew the curtains back, and there's Darth Vader's suit. It was just like a moment, you know what I mean? I was like, oh my God, Darth Vader. You know, I've only seen this guy for 30 years, and I was there, the suit, I put it on, I got into the character, and the character came to me, because every character I play, it's got a presence and a spirit, right? And one of them happens, it really takes over me. So I was thinking to myself, there's no way they can be, can't be a real spirit presence of Darth Vader, can't be. So when he came to me, the atmosphere changed in the room and the voice came through to me and everything. It was just, it was a moment. Oh yeah, you're there with me right now, because it was a moment and it was just, my life changed. So it was awesome.
Can you, when you're in costume, is there like a mirror? Can you see yourself actually?
Well, I'm inside the suit, but I really, really do get into the character. So it's like looking through a window. It's a bit weird, but you can see through. When I was walking through the steam at the ship, as soon as the steam hits you, you glide, because it's like a pretty, like a red plastic, thick visor, you know? It's like 30% before the steam hits you. So you've got to use the force out of that, you know what I mean?
Now, did they talk at all? And I've seen, like, when you're on Mustafar, which is Vader's lava planet, did they mention it all? That's where you were? Did you know?
No.
They did a very good job of keeping that secret. As you watch the movie, they label the name of every planet they go to. You know, Yavin, Nuar, and all. They don't mention Mustafar. They want it to be a total surprise.
Yeah, nothing. We knew nothing.
But me and my nerd friends, we saw it, we were like, Mustafar! You know?
Because it's always going to be the living legend, James Earl Jones, who's going to do the voice. I'm sure they've got to read the dictionary, you know? He's always going to Darth Vader's voice, right? But they give me additional dialogue, you know, because obviously it's a time, let's say 2 minutes, between me and Krennic, right? So, I'll never forget it, right? Because it was the first sort of show and tell we did with the director, and they set up a big speaker, you know, because nobody's heard me do the voice. They thought I was just going to read the dialogue. But when I got back into the character, do you want to do the dialogue for me, what I did?
Yes.
Yes.
So there was a moment when I come for the scene, and there's a moment between me and Craig. So I went, don't be too sure that the Emperor is as impressed with you as you are with yourself, Director. Reckless ambition is not a quality of lies, but your efforts also be. Oh, sorry, man, I was just getting, yeah, so there you go, that's done, the whole one.
Woo!
That's pretty good, you know, you got that, the bass sound.
Yeah, yeah. It was funny because after the breathing as anything, they were going to me, I was going, and they go, Sven, it's all right, we'll put the breathing in later, you know.
Now, what you just recited, that sounds like, was that actual, that actually wasn't in the film, but was that dialogue that was shot?
That was the dialogue they gave me on that scene.
So I understand they changed that scene a lot. Yeah,
you know, it's that scene, because I'd never talk about what we're doing on the film anyway. We can't, but that was the actual dialogue they gave me in that scene.
So. Oh, I love that line that he has where it's, don't show your aspirations.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I had to find out that when I watched the film.
I thought it was a great line, and a lot of people thought it was too much of a joke, a pun for Darth Vader. In the New Hope, he does the same exact thing. He says, I find your lack of faith disturbing.
Yeah.
You know, it's the same kind of humor, the same kind of joke.
Yeah.
We're going to be opening these up to a mic there in the back for the audience in about 15, 20 minutes. We're going to open it up for questions. Hopefully, we'll open it up and raise here.
Yeah.
But I do have a question online from Rebel Force Radio. It's from Rick Reitow, and he wants to know, as you go to these conventions, what's the craziest thing you've been asked to sign?
Kids again?
Like, what's the craziest non-vulgar thing you've had to sign?
I'm not going to say it. Everything. A guy came up to me in the opticians. I had to go for some contacts for a job that I was working on. And this young lad, he's about 21, 22, in my hometown in Rhyl, it's a very small town in North Wales where the sea meets the mountains, it's beautiful. I know, we've got some great families there. He come running in, and the film had only been out a few weeks. He goes, oh, Sven, can you come? I've got a paper. Can you sign my arm? I went, yeah, no problem. An hour later on Facebook, he went and got a tattoo. It's a picture. I went, wow.
Jesus.
You know, and it was, I loved his passion. You know, it was great. It's like you guys, you're passionate about your thing, it's awesome. That was it.
That's probably the greatest thing. Each had to you.
He had to have to.
That you would put on.
I signed his arm. I went, I thought you would wash it off the day after. And he went, got it tattooed.
Well, that's commitment. Yeah,
it is. I hope he can stick it when he goes into the bank.
I have another question from Rebel Force Radio from Raymond Medila. Not including the people Darth Vader has already fought, who would you like to see Darth Vader fight if you could do so in the future, in a future film? What character would you like to see Darth Vader fight? So it would be excluding Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I'd like to tear him with Chewbacca or something like that.
Well, he's here. You know, is it
really? Chewie here? Yeah, that'd be awesome. Yeah. Or just, you know, did all like the soldiers start turning him, and he just starts taking out his own stormtroopers or something. Just got really like that. He's just got two doctors and a dark office. No, you're not going to go. I forget about that one.
Okay, it looks like.
Awkward.
So we're going to need the word that Ray's going to be here in a couple of minutes.
Right, cool.
We'll just have a couple more Darth Vader questions. So, other than Darth Vader, who would you say Darth Vader was your favorite character before all of this started?
You know, I'm good friends with every character I played. You know, he's an amazing character, and he's just another awesome character I've played. You know, he's Darth Vader. He's opened the doorway for everybody else to learn about all my characters. I've been over 40 characters, you know. The first character I ever played was the werewolf, the Prisoner of Azkaban. That was my first role. And then I went to Batman Begins and Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy and just kept on going. So to play Darth Vader was, you know, it was a real honor for the Emperor to allow me to, you know, steer his Death Star.
Would you, of course, you'd be open for playing bigger in the future if such a bar arrives?
If that vote happens, you know, I couldn't tell you anything if any such a moment.
Are you pivoting, or are you really saying that?
Like you said.
Poker face? No, I'm just kidding. So who's your favorite Star Wars character?
I love Chewie, but I love Princess Leia and all of them, you know, God rest his soul. It's just like before that, I love everything to do with Star Wars, man. It's just it's not just about Darth Vader, Star Wars, it's about the whole crew. Everybody put a little bit of their magic in there, do you know what I mean? So I just love the whole film. I've got a favorite bit, it's the whole one.
We do have a mic in the center. If anybody has a question for Mr. Watley, I think someone's coming up. Oh no, he's a volunteer. But the mic will be open here if anybody is feeling brave enough to do so. Do you have any favorite movies of your own? Movies you like to?
I like The Wizard of Oz and things like that. Do you know what I mean? E.T. One of them. Do you know what I mean? Those sort of films. Superman, Batman.
We have a mic.
Is this a Q&A going on here now, right now, or what?
I'm asking you a question and you're answering. That's a Q&A. I think someone's standing in front of the mic.
All right, cool.
And it happens to be the owner of the dog.
What sort of dog is it?
He's a party Walsh Corgi, actually. Go say hi. Yeah, he's actually a service dog. It's his first convention. So he was walking around the staff members.
Running away from him.
The staff members had to freak him out, but yeah, good boy, Miller. Yeah, you got some love from Jeffrey. Good boy. So I just wanted to know what was it like it being such a huge character, assuming that mantle, because it's so iconic, you know, knowing that. You're
going
to now have to live up to James Earl Jones and
then
the actor that physically portrayed him before you.
You know, to play that character, like I say, the presence and spirit took over me. He was Darth Vader, man. That was it. He's always going to be one Darth Vader. And it's just a step out of the body and just enjoy him. Do you know what I mean? Did you get that? Cool.
Again, I just wanted to apologize for him barking.
Well, I'm going to apologize. He's talking. that's a mean dog thing, though.
No,
did you get the dog's name, by the way? What was the dog's name?
Miller, yep.
Miller Lite?
He's actually named after the Steve Miller band, but what? Everyone thinks it's Miller Lite, yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. Okay, we have another question.
So, I'm just wondering, what is your favorite part about playing Darth Vader? Like, the fact that you can force-choke people? You make these smart comments?
I can attest to that.
What's your favorite part about it?
Feeling his presence. And he's got respect in mind. He's Darth Vader. And, you know, obviously, with all the force that you can use as well, it's always good. You know, I mean, I was passing at home, you know, looking at cars and stuff like that. Choking out your brother. He lives in a different city as well, so he was like, didn't know what was going on. He's like, you want to come? Yes, I'm. Just practicing.
Okay, we have another question here.
Yeah. I'm just curious what your favorite movie you were in was. Which was your favorite portrayal that you got to do?
Well, I'm not saying all of them, but like from the martial arts, because I used to be a martial artist and a professional boxer back in the day. That was, the boxing ring was my dream machine, right? Because I lived two dreams through the boxing. I became a Welsh British European kickboxing champion, undefeated pro boxer. But that opened up the doorway for the film world. But I landed in Batman Begins, Leaving the Shadow of Warrior 1. And I thought, when I landed back on the game, I thought, great, we'll get to do some of the kickboxing. You know what I mean? We're playing ninjas and stuff. You know, but they didn't allow it, because all the stunts took over that. So it took like 13 years for me to get to do some of my martial arts on screen, and that was a film called Green Street. Do you know that?
Yeah.
It's a hooligan film. So I played a character, yeah, you know it? Cool. Well, Green Street 3, never back down. It's a Lionsgate film. It went straight to DVD. And I'm the head baddie in it. I'm the head of the wall. But it was also the head special flagship. You know what I mean? One of them guys. Which was awesome. So I got to do a lot of kickboxing on that film. And when I was growing up, my mum used to say, stop kicking people, stop being a monster. There was something in it, right? I'm only five. So I got to play a lot of monsters as well, like Doctor Who and things like that, and Game of Thrones, and, you know, it's cool. Thanks, great question.
My son just wants to say, I love Story Theater, like more than anything.
Hey, buddy, what's your name?
Evan.
How are you doing, Evan? Are you going to come to the dark side? It looks like you're already there. Yeah! Woo! Dark side room. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
See you later, Evan. Be good. You got to be good. Come to the dark side.
Is he wearing a Darth Vader costume?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's your grandson.
Close enough.
Enjoy. Let me see. Take care, bro.
Have you had a chance to meet Adam Driver?
No.
But yeah, it's not that it'd be kind of cool if he was
possible.
It'd be cool to see him visually too, yeah.
You know, it's just awesome to, I met Ray Park for the first time in Megacon, in Orlando. And I said, oh, Ray, you know, I'm thinking to myself, I hope he talks to me. He's cool, and I hope we get on. But straight away, when I met Ray, he was just super cool. And I said, oh, Ray, can I throw you over my shoulders when I have a selfie? And he goes, no. I'll sit on your shoulders and went, yeah. So, you see on the net, you know, Darth Maul sitting on Darth Vader's shoulders, it's like, you know, the dark side is in it now and again. You know what I mean?
You know, it'd be really cool if you two did a panel together. Next question.
You never know what might happen.
So, in the last scene of Rogue One, how did you kind of throw up a reference? Did you
have to
do that physically, or was it something?
No.
When do you start filming the next movie? No, I'm kidding. That's a good trick question. It would be great if I didn't answer that.
Can you rank the Star Wars movies?
Can I rank them?
Ooh. Your favorite, your second favorite.
Return of the Jedi, probably. I love Return of the Jedi. All the old school ones, I love them a bit. You know, ones are all great, but I'm an old school boy, and I really like what he did with Rogue One, because it was like going back old school. That was my feelings on it. It was like awesome. What do you reckon?
So Return of the Jedi would be your favorite of all eight Star Wars movies.
Yeah, exactly.
Return of the Jedi. That's an interesting selection. Yeah. You just like Empire or New Hope?
No, I like Return
of the
Jedi.
Mine's a New Hope.
Is it?
Because Tarkin, I'm a big Tarkin fan. I love Tarkin. So Rogue One, he turned around. Yeah. I'm looking. I worked with this one, a joy designer and so forth. I had a lot of artwork that I knew about when the movie came out, but I had no idea Tarkin was going to be the level he was.
Was that even Darth Vader?
No, not really well. Tarkin turned around. He started, you know, making, you know, sandwich orders, whatever it was he was saying. It was fantastic. Got another question from the audience.
Yes, you were the werewolf from Prisoner of Azkaban and the thug from Guardians of the Galaxy. Which of the characters did you find harder to physical portray with the makeup and the CGI?
When
when I was in Green Lantern, I didn't find it hard, but it was probably hard for the people to watch what I was doing, because Kilowog, you know Kilowog in Green Lantern? That's the character I played in New Orleans. I was there for 4 months. And I was on stilts, it took me like to 9 feet high. Do you know what I mean? So I was walking on the side of the and people are going, I said, you'll see, when the computer puts it in, it's like a three-quarter of a turn, alien, you know, welcome to Return to World War. You know what I mean? That guy, he's nuts. But he was, every time I'd do the scene, I'd go, oh, because he was greedy with my energy, he was talking, do you know what I mean? But yeah, that was a, yeah, probably looked a bit silly on set.
Careful about choking on your aspirations, Spencer.
Wow, we got it.
You
don't even
make my job
anymore. Cool, man. All right, so it would be a good idea to do a fan of
Ray
Park, I think.
I think so.
Yeah, yeah, he is here, so Sith Lord Darth Maul himself, Ray Park. Wow, you boss around drinks.
Hey, Humpty Dumpty, got them all.
I love this guy.
I'm sorry for being late. I had to save the world in my dreams. We had a good night last night, yeah?
It was awesome. I love this, because it's like a front scene. Like me.
Mine was spinning. It feels very warm just from sitting
here. Yeah, thanks.
Did you fart on my seat?
No, it was
very warm.
I originally had that seat, but he's bigger than me, so I had to get that out a lot.
Hey, have you checked out Spencer's videos on YouTube? Put your hands up. Shame on you! Check this man out, man. Check him out. Go on YouTube and check. This guy is legit.
I'm not just saying that because I'm hungover.
You're not. Me and Ray would do the caterpillar on it. It was a bad excuse. One of my excuses. We're not going to get a bit drunk. We're friends. He's a great soul. He really is. If you get a chance to have a drink, we may have a drink. And then. We're in a moment. And I said. I think the security guard told us off a bit of it, noisy at the bar, I went, right, okay. I dropped down into the caterpillar, but it didn't work.
You did
caterpillar? We
did a caterpillar,
mate. I can't remember that. Dad did a
caterpillar. Mate,
did a caterpillar.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It looked like I was having a fit, I've lost the kids.
That's what happens when you reach 40.
Yeah, I get from that going to 40.
45?
43
this year.
July 26th.
July. That's
why you're
so well with you.
Leo.
Leo,
you're the
right
man.
I love you
more.
I'm
going to
get off
from you now.
Hey,
well, stop it. Don't. Stop it.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. I'm not at home anymore. So my apologies for keeping you waiting.
Sorry.
We did go out last night. We did break the ice a little bit. Yeah, we just like tear it up. You heard it? Ripped the carpet. Apparently we calculated it. So I'm a little hungover, so that kid's not here.
Don't try to catch
him. So unless you want to be the dark side.
So I got to ask, because you know, Foxwoods Resort Casino's got a lot of great places. Where'd you guys go to? Do you remember?
We were in Red Lantern. It was called the Hen. What do you call it in America? It's called the Stag Dunes.
And Hen Parties.
Hen Parties. Yeah. There's a lot of Hen Parties last night.
It was such a good day.
It was Bachelorette.
Yes. Yeah.
So there was a lot going on last night. It was great. Celebrate.
good energy.
Yeah. We try to get across the dinosaur, just didn't happen, we just got boobies, man.
Yeah, but you said
Yeah, you did it. Yeah,
that's true. What I really like about this convention is that once you leave here, there's anything you want to do, there's something out there for you within a couple hundred yards.
What a place. What a place. All I wanted to do was get 100 pennies and play the one-armed bandit and win a million, but I didn't get to do that because you and I were capitalists.
That's been a hold
So, go ahead.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead. This gentleman here is awesome. We've worked so many times in the past. Can you understand what I'm saying? It's a force strong with everyone.
Yes.
Say Star Wars!
Star Wars!
Yo, Joe!
Yo, Joe!
I was like,
Yo, Joe.
Alright, so there's more Star Wars fans here, yeah? This gentleman here, what's your name?
Kevin.
I don't know. We worked so much in the past, he's a great guy. He's a friend. I've seen him all over the world, and thank you for being here on a Sunday morning with this tall big geezer. And his swiveling chair, and not my static chair. I would love to have the swiveling chair.
Oh man, yeah, these chairs actually get progressively less comfortable. I keep moving this one's like that nearly my
strap. This one's still warm.
And that one, would you stop it with that?
My mom is burning right now. What have you been doing?
Eating it too
last night. My bum is burning. Spencer, man, look, listen. I'm telling you right now, I'm looking at you, Ninja Turtles, and you. YouTube. When you're done, go and check him out. You do not want to get a roundhouse kick from this guy.
I've been around the house and kicked you. I know if I were to ask either one of you who would win the fight, Darth Maul or Darth Vader.
Oh.
So I'm gonna have to ask it this way. Give reason to why you think your character.
In the past, I would have said Maul, but after meeting Spencer,
So you would give the fight to Darth Vader, because I know he'll say Darth Vader.
We would never fight. We would always team up.
I think we'd be warriors in past lives, and we'd be together, then we fought wars together in this game. Yeah. For sure.
Remember that movie with Tom Cruise when he was in Japan? That's
The Last Samurai.
That's us.
Okay. So how about this? On Coruscant, there would be like a charity event boxing match between Darth Maul and Darth Vader. Is that good enough?
Well, you guys are still on your
same side. I'll be his corner. I'll be his corner.
It's like two of us would be like, alright, Mr. Jedi, let's go.
That's not. We wouldn't even have to hate him. We should
not. I don't know.
I'm telling you, I'm saying it again. Sorry, Spencer. Check out Spencer. I'm telling you right now. Check him out, man. Legit.
Check us out as soon as we leave here. That seems pretty interesting.
Yeah, you wouldn't be asking us questions if you hadn't checked him out.
A bit of bromance going on here.
This is the first panel you two have ever done together. Yes.
I found out 20 minutes ago.
When
are you, man? When you right, I'm here. Everyone's waiting. And I'm like, what do you mean? Yeah. Turn together? Oh, I'm sorry, man. Okay, I'll hurry up. Keep Spence waiting.
I've been so excited.
A massive
bass. I'm so excited to get your cousin.
What was the last memory we had last night? I remember being at the bar
going, Ron Coleman.
Was that the last movie I had last night?
That's it, we were in Bill Cummins' gambit for a bit, and then we just went, and we went to the bar, and we sat down and had our, we had a lot of fun, and that really happened. I said, can you do this?
That's just like, I'm off for a minute.
Running man.
How is everyone today? Woo! Happy Father's Day.
Another week.
Next week. I know. Hey, happy Father's Day for next week. That's the one thing. Throughout the United Kingdom and America, Father's Day is the same. Mother's Day is twice for me. Because it's earlier in the US than it is for the UK. So I got some flowers twice in my mind. I don't mind. I love flowers. But raising your kids, I said to my wife, we're British, yeah? but we live in America, we're Americans. Well, and so, but it's good shit. But we only get one Father's Day in America. It's the same. You know, I got married on Father's Day.
Yeah. You guys got married on Father's Day, too?
Yeah? Congratulations.
Hey, bud.
Got you? Yeah. Woo! We've 18 years of marriage.
You've been married for 18 years?
Yeah, almost.
So that's, you got married right around the time the Bat Mess came out, I guess.
Well, my wife and I were together then. We got married afterwards. My my grandmother, her grandmother, I consider my wife's grandparents my grandparents, and she goes,
"Right, so when are you going to make an honest woman of my granddaughter?" And I'm,
"Yes, ma'am." I'm Dylan. My younger brother had his first kid, Dylan. Love Dylan. I think he's 13, 14 now. And I remember looking at my brother's eyes, and he was just like, "It's my little brother, yeah, I'm the oldest." So, and he was looking at him like with such awe. And I will never forget that look, seeing a dad looking at his son for the first time. I never remember that my dad looking at me like that when I was a baby. But my brother looking at his boy, and I was like, "Hey, it's just married." And that's because of my son, because of Dylan getting married, being born. I always wanted to have a million in the bank, have a house, have a Ferrari, but it's never happened. You never plan for it, but it's just what I love. Love is an important thing. It's the big, it's L-O-V-E, something great about that word. So forget the millions, forget the Ferrari, which you're going to be bald or old, you know,
right?
Grab a love biker. And go
with it. So, I'm going to say,
looks like. I feel that love.
Yeah, it's like, forget the money. It's not about the money. Looks like we have somebody with the mic over there, and I hope it's a Star Wars question.
Which one of you two do you think would win in a force arm wrestle contest?
If. Force choke, what we're doing it?
Not for show, no go. Hey, we'll do it for charity, though.
That'd be fun.
We'll make it happen.
Yeah, we'll make it fun. Yeah, mic is still open if anybody has a question from the audience. Looks like someone's running us right now. While he's doing that, I just got a quick question for you. Over here, Red. Can I host my
panel?
Okay, great. I got a question from Austin Foe from Rebel Force Radio. Did you ever? Oh, you know those guys? Yeah, they're good guys. Did you ever follow any Darth Maul stories on Clone Wars or Rebels? Didn't follow at all. I got some bad news for you.
I am Darth Maul. I was, but I have not read anything because I'm not a very good reader. I don't have any glasses, so every time
it's a TV show.
Show?
It's a TV show.
Oh,
it's actually, it's a cartoon.
Say it again.
Clone Wars and Rebel Force.
Oh, yeah, Rebels. Clone Wars I've watched.
Okay.
I love Clone Wars. Dave Filoni did a great job. But when I started to watch Rebels, it's a different animation. But please don't quote me or it's a great pop doesn't like Rebels. Anything to do with Star Wars, I love watching. But I'm a Star Wars fan. I've watched Star Wars. My DVR doesn't record it in sequence. So when Clone Wars came out, my son and I watched it, and I fell in love with the Mandalorian nerds. I love the nerds. If they ask me back to be in a Star Wars movie, I love being nerd.
My question was, did you follow at all Darth Maul's portrayal in Clone Wars and Rebels?
Sam did an awesome job. Have you seen Sam? Work.
Sam Witwer is the voice actor for Darth Maul in the series, and he's also the Starkiller from.
So I'm in Kilo Mass. It's been a little bit more in Mexico, I think.
Kitimat's a famous place, takeout eating place in LA. And I'm standing in line, look, moody, and I get a little tap on the shoulder. It was Sam, the first time I met him about 4 years ago. And then he voices start going. And he's a great actor, best impulse in the business, best lips in the business. He's a handsome fella, and he's a good, great actor as well. So I'm so happy that he voices Darth Maul in the cartoons.
And he's a huge Star Wars fan. We're talking.
Yeah,
I mean, I like to think I know a lot about Star Wars, but this guy is, he's good.
This guy's fit. Right? He's a fit guy as well, so I like him. He's awesome and very charismatic.
We also had a question earlier for Spencer, but I wanted to ask you, what's the craziest thing you've ever signed? You saw, oh, you were the guy who signed the tattoo for him?
He's
craziest thing.
You know, I will tell you the first time I signed someone's body, and I remember this because it's like being at Dragon Con. I don't know if you've ever been to Dragon Con. So this young lady was like, hey, can you sign that movie? Can you hear about Peter Townsend and you hear about all these rock stars, you know, and Nick is in the mail and stuff like that. And so I was like, what?
Good job.
Yeah. So I was like, what? So it's kind of weird for me. So her boyfriend was like, go on, bro. He's like, son of a bitch. My wife was there. So I was like, oh, awkward. Like, how do I do this? I've never done this before. No one tells you when you sign up for a movie that's what you're going to be doing. That's 20 years ago. And then after I signed it, I was very polite, very respectful. He goes, bro, watch out, your hands are going, bro, that's my wife. I'm like, just encourage me to do it. And ever since then, I never do anything like that. If anyone wants to do that, never. But I do sign arms, and I've signed legs, and I've got used to it. But when I was on Star Wars, I never thought that I'd be sitting here with Spencer with you talking about movies. I always thought I'd be doing demonstrations about martial arts and seminars. And my friend, who's a PA on the movie, he was also a PA on Mortal Kombat, the first movie, he laughed. He goes, you know what? You're going to be signing autographs for the rest of your life. I'm like, shut up. I never thought that was real. And here we are. We're here talking about Star Wars. And when I get asked questions, I'm like, you've got to forgive me, please. I'm like, 20 years ago, I was 20 years old.
20 years old.
In the moment, I was just doing it. Loved martial arts. Anything to do with Jackie Chan, Donnie Yen, the NBL, Sam Lahal, Bruce Lee, Chuck Norris, Steven Seagal. You know, anything to do with ninjas, I was. What about you, mate? What about you?
Yeah, I was a Van Damme boy. Yeah, Bruce Lee and all that lot. Yeah. We all, you know, we're close in age, right?
Yeah.
We grew up with that. You know what I mean? So I was, as my mum used to tell me off for kicking all the time. I mean, stop kicking. We had a boxing family. My uncle Carl gives him an addition to Joe Budman, poor Joe Mandel, sparred with Muhammad Ali 4 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Really? Yeah. Yeah, he had the best job in the business back in the day. That was awesome. So, yeah, that's a kickboxer. I love Van Damme. I specialise in the sidekick from Van Damme. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, boom, straight up, second life, like, two times that.
You know what? I watched The Quest a few days ago.
TV.
I have DirecTV.
We all do.
Okay. So, I was anti-TV for a while. Because I remember watching, there was a Star Wars cartoon was on MTV at the time, and they were showing adult purposes on Saturday morning. So I was like, get off the grid. So I cancelled my TV because I didn't believe my kids should be able to watch that kind of thing. It wasn't there for them, you know? And so for a long time, for 3 years, we didn't have TV. And it was boring, you know? It was really boring at home. This is like, what are we going to watch? And then I found out later, like, I just plugged an aerial in the back. I could have free TV for a while. And we missed, and you know what got me back onto DirecTV? It was the World Championships of football. Soccer.
Yeah.
my daughter plays in the.
You're not rambling, it's interesting, mate. Yeah.
So, I was just saying, Mr. Spencer, so I was watching Van Damme, and I doubled for James Remar in Mortal Kombat. And it was great watching that movie, because I remember watching, I got on, don't tell anyone, I got on Pirate DVD. And I remember you used to get a CD, you know, like DVD discs, but it was a CD, but it, so I had the latest DVD player, but it was CD. Was it CD?
You lost me, man.
So I had the, my brother goes, hey, remember when you had it? I had the glasses, you watch all the movies. And that's when I'm out getting the Samsung. I had it 20 years ago from Hong Kong. It's the best. And so I used to watch the Jack Chan movies, and that's the quest for Van Damme and James Remar brings back a lot of memories. James must have done that movie after Mortal Kombat, and he was my favorite character in Warriors. Have you seen Warriors?
Warriors
come after me. Ajax, man, he was just the best. So I had the honor of he was the best guy. Like, I loved work with him. He was just the best.
So, looks like we have a bad question. I'm sorry.
I'm
waffling
on or not?
No, that's all right. Kind of funny. Yes, sir, what's your question?
Were you happy about the fate of your character at the end of episode one? You know, getting cut in half and shoved down the giant tube?
You know what? Excuse me. I already knew it. So I'm going to say this, I've said it many times before. I knew how my character was going to end. I knew how episode 2 and 3 was going to happen. To me as a kid, I was a kid only 22. Bad guys are going to get it. It's all about Vader. The emphasis was, it's the story of Vader. But originally, we were trying to sort of pitch my head getting cut off. But George felt like it was too gruesome. And then Nick Gillard, the stunt coordinator, he said, if you cut you in half, there may be a possibility they can bring you back.
Oh, yeah.
They want to hear.
Yeah, can you hear me now? Yep,
I can hear you just fine.
I will project my voice like a thespian. I'm not. Yeah, so I knew how the ending was going to be, and we had this different view on how the fight was going to be. Well, I was telling someone yesterday that the walkway we were fighting on, I was like crazy mad, like I am now, slicing the platform, and the Jedi's were sliding down. We had this different view on the end fight, but George decided on what it is now. And I always joke about the ending, and like, you look at my face, because as a kid, I was always the cop in the playground. I was never the robber, you know, playing cops and robbers. So I was always a good guy. I didn't know how to die. I never pretended to be dead in the playground. Never did it, ever. So I was like, how do I keep cutting him off? I don't know. What is it like to be cut?
I'm trying to be a method. I'm trying to be an actor.
And it's like, the only thing I could think of was having a bad curry on a Wednesday night. Whenever you look at my face, and I go, that was a bad curry on a Wednesday. Because Wednesday was my day off, because gymnastics, they had recreational gymnastics, they had parent, blah, blah, so I couldn't train at a gym. So that was my day off, Wednesday. You know, I trained Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, when I was 18, 17, 15.
Cool. Thank you for your question. And, young man.
I know how you had a 1v1 lightsaber duel.
Hey,
I know how you had a 1v1 duel with Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon. Which one did you like better?
Both. They were good. They were different fights. I don't know if you go back and watch the fights, with Liam Neeson, he was a tech fighter. And with Ewan, we were both Scottish, I was like, come on, mate, let's go. Let's do this. I'm gonna give you the milk here. Right, so if you watch the movie, you can see me going like this before he goes to the beam.
And that was both of us going, come on, let's go. Plus my grand was watching. God bless her, she passed away. But my mum and dad, my grand, my dad watching, so I had to do it good. And my dad goes, what are you doing this for? Is this a hobby? So that fight sequence, my parents were watching, and that was me going, come on, let's go, let's do this. What did you prefer?
I liked you versus Obi-Wan much better than you versus Qui-Gon.
You know that fight was called 3-2-1. Remember?
Yeah, that's the bit.
3-2-1.
Yeah.
We called it 3-2-1 fight. Because we just made it up. Andres Petrides is a phenomenal stunt performer, phenomenal person. We would just make stuff up. And then, oh, that was great. What did we do? So we started filming everything to remember. And that's how the fight, we called it donut fight. Donut. I don't know if you remember when I go like this, the kick, to Qui-Gon, and Qui-Gon hits me. That was made up on the spot. Like, because Nick Gillard was like, come on! George is out here on the scene! Because so we were all stressed out. So we're like, I forgot this, and we just made it up, and we filmed it 2 seconds later. That was the fight. How about you, man? How was it?
How was the ending?
Everything.
Well, for Darth Vader, Star Wars, that was awesome, man. For the Star Wars film, now I played Darth Vader, man.
Yeah.
Yes. Dark side. Yes. Well, it. That was cool. That was good.
Sorry, man. I feel like I'm talking to you now. Sorry.
It's a cute idea.
What's the last one?
Okay. It's just important that you showed up. Ashley, best question, sir.
If you could have a duel with any one Jedi, who would it be?
You know, it was great that George. Are you asking me or asking Spencer?
Do Master Paul. Paul.
Oh. Ask Spencer.
I'll be walking over here. I'll go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, for sure. I know we've done it in the past, but you know.
You know, Ewan wants to come back on Star Wars, which is great. And I remember, everyone goes, how's the makeup? I was on Mortal Kombat, so it took 4 hours for prosthetic on Baraka. It was the most boring job I ever had. Yeah, I had to wear some prosthetics, I think it was in the bathroom. But I loved it. And I thought, is this movie making? I don't know if I want to do this anymore. It wasn't what I thought it was. I grew up believing in everything I saw in the film. And then when I landed Darth Maul, it was only 2 hours. Only 2 hours. For me, Ewan come in every morning singing, yeah. But he didn't know I was Scottish. So I kept it a secret. And it was the best secret I kept. Until my mum and dad came to visit the last fight scene. The very last thing we filmed was the film scene. My grand was there, my dad's the best friend there. Throws in. Marbles in him out. And Ewan turns around on the bus because we filmed everything at Leaston where they filmed Harry Potter. But they used to make the Rolls Royce engines at this warehouse where we filmed it. And Ewan turns around, hey, I didn't know you were Scottish. And I said, well, I'm not going to tell you, am I? Because I'm like, all right, mate, they do. And of course, I'm speaking Scottish to my mum and dad and my grand. Because my dad goes, if I speak English, my daddy goes, what's that? What's that? So I go, all right, Dad, I'm sorry. So Ewan turned around. Because I didn't know you were Scottish. So, like I was saying earlier, when I was doing this, that made it even more personal. Because Ewan knew I was Scottish. And I was like, come on, let's go. And then that's why the fight was so good, because we had that passion. Not because we're Scottish, I think.
Ian is Scottish as well. The Emperor.
Yeah, Ian's Scottish as well, yeah.
And so is Ewan's uncle, Dennis Lawson, who's a good friend of mine. He's from Scotland as well.
We're jocks in the mix, you know what I mean?
Absolutely. So,
I love Ian McDermott, yeah. I've said to Stuart, who looks after Ian, if Ian could be my master, and I mean this, like, he's such a good actor, like, the best being traditional actor, I would love to run with him. I'd love to just be, what's the word for when then you were understudy. I love to get an understudy of him. Like, he's just perfect.
Yeah, he's very good stuff. Unfortunately, that's going to have to go. No more questions.
Will you? Well,
somebody came late. But these,
hey, I'm not for 20 minutes.
Oh, yeah, you were before. Sorry for being late.
Well, if you'd like to hear the conclusion to this discussion, both these gentlemen will be downstairs in the autograph hall. They both, I believe, have photo ops later this afternoon.
Listen, I'm going to take 5 questions. Put your hands up. If you've got a question, I haven't answered it yet. I've answered.
If you had to choose between the dark side and the light side, what would you pick?
Good question. So when Nick Gillard asks me to come in, I was in my GB tracksuit, Great Britain, ready to perform, had all my spears, my cudgels, bow staffs, swords, everything. But he told me, it's me doing box splits, I can't do it anymore. Well, I can if the camera's rolling. But doing space across the chairs, done it for him. He said, yeah, you got a job. He was talking to me about a bike ride, and I was kind of thinking, oh, yeah, that's good, yeah, I'm not a stuntman, just finished doing Mortal Kombat, that's what I want to do, I want to get movies. Why is he asking me to come in to be a bad guy? Why can't I be a Jedi? You know? I never thought in a million years that I would end up playing Darth Maul. And then, after 2 hours of talking to Nick, and he showed me the storyboards, and showed me the character, and I was like, oh, both stuff. He introduced me to Rick McCallum, the executive producer. George wasn't there yet. And I was like, wow, 4 hours later, so we meet. But second movie, I knew that was a good thing. You know, I've been in a meeting for 4 hours. It's pretty cool. And then I got a job. So I kind of wish, I was
They're going to fire me. They're not going to fire you.
Anyone else? 4 more questions!
what is your favorite
Star Wars
character?
Han Solo.
Okay, next.
2 more questions. Who's after us?
I don't know who's after me.
Who's after me? Us?
Sean Mayer.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sean. 2 more questions. Ask Spencer, please.
You still handle a lightsaber?
Yes, he can. Next question.
Every day when I cook, that's all I say. Hey, for G.I. Joe 1, I was trying to like, show you.
He's gone. I'd like to thank you for coming to my last panel.
Favorite martial arts move?